Hello everyone, I am Aman Dilip of Fortran Civil Service Academy. Through this video, I would like to discuss about three important women freedom fighters of India. So let's get into our video. Firstly, I would like to discuss some points about Rani Lakshmibai. Rani Lakshmibai was one of the leading warriors of India's first struggle for independence. A symbol of bravery, patriotism and honor, Rani Lakshmibai was born on 19 November 1828 at Pune. Her actual name was Manikarnika. She grew up with Nana Sahib and Tatiya Tok, who were active participants in the first revolt for independence. In 1842, Rani Lakshmibai got married to Raja Gangadhar Rao, who was the Maharaja of Jhansi. After her marriage, she came to be known as Lakshmibai. Maharaja Gangadhar Rao got died on 21st November 1853. When the Maharaja died, Rani Lakshmibai was just 18 years old, but she didn't lose her courage and took up her responsibility. Lord Dalhousie, the Governor General of India at that time, planned to annex Jhansi on the ground that it did not have any legal heir. In March 1854, Rani of Jhansi was granted an annual pension of 60,000 rupees and was ordered to leave the Jhansi fort. She was firm on the decision not to give up the domain of Jhansi to the British. For strengthening the defense of Jhansi, Rani Lakshmibai assembled an army of rebellions, which also included women. She assembled 14,000 rebels and organized an army for the defense of the city. In March 1858, when the British attacked Jhansi, Rani Lakshmibai's army decided to fight the war and continued about 2 weeks. The army fought very bravely even though Jhansi lost to the British forces. On the unfortunate day of 17 June of 1858, this great warrior martyred her life for India's freedom. Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu was an Indian independence activist and poet who earned the sobriquet of Nightingale of India. She was born in a Bengali family, Hindu family in Hyderabad. She was educated in Chennai, London and Cambridge. She took part in the Indian nationalist movement, became a follower of Mahatma Gandhi and fought for the attainment of Swaraj or independence. She became the president of Indian National Congress and was later appointed as governor of the United Provinces, now Uttar Pradesh. Known as the Nightingale of India, she was also a noted poet. Her poetry includes children's poems, nature poems, patriotic poems and poems of love and death. She also wrote poetry in praise of Muslim figures like Imam Hussein in a time where Muslim-Hindu tensions ran high in pre-independence era. When issues regarding the split of India into a Muslim country and a Hindu country had already begun, and as she had got an intercaste and inter-regional marriage in a time where this was uncommon. Her goal was to bring all of India together regardless of any caste or religion. Sarojini Naidu died of cardiac arrest on 2nd March of 1949 at the government house in Lucknow. Now thirdly, I would like to discuss some important points about another woman independent fight leader, Krishna Nehru Ate Singh. Krishna Nehru Ate Singh was an Indian writer and also the younger sister of Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India. She was born in 1907 in Mirganj, which is in Allahabad. She was married to Raja Ate Singh, who belonged to the prominent Ahmedabad Jain family that built the Ate Singh Jain Temple. She and her husband fought for India's independence and spent a great deal of time in jail while raising their two children, Harsha Ate Singh and Ajit Ate Singh. Ms. Ate Singh documented her life as well as the lives of her brother Jawaharlal and her niece Indira Gandhi in a series of books that intertwined history with personal anecdotes, including V. Nehru's With No Regrets, Nehru's letters to his sister and dear beloved. She was associated with the Voice of America and gave several talks. She died in Washington DC in 1967. So now it's time to conclude my video, and Thank you so much for watching this.